Welcome to study session 2, Rheumatoid Arthritis. Introduction. We commence this course discussing generally the autoimmune disorders. In this session, we will focus on one of the autoimmune disorder, rheumatoid arthritis, RA. In doing so, we will explain the pathophysiology of RA. We will also outline the stages of RA and consider the management procedure of clients with RA. Learning outcomes. When you have studied this session, you should be able to 1. Define and use correctly the term rheumatoid arthritis, RA. 2. Explain pathophysiology of RA. 3. Identify the stages of RA. 4. Consider management procedure of clients with RA. What is rheumatoid arthritis? Rheumatoid arthritis, RA, is a systemic autoimmune inflammation of connective tissue. It is chronic, progressive diseases involving inflammation and synovial joints. It is characterized by periods of remissions and exacerbations. The incidence is 3 times greater in women than in men. Peak age of onset is between age 30 and 60, but the disease can develop at any age. Causes and pathophysiology. The exact cause is unknown, but genetic and environmental factors are contributory. T cells, B cells, and the orchestrated interaction of pro-inflammatory cytokines play key roles in the pathophysiology of RA. Differentiation of naive T cells into Th17 cells results in the production of IL-17, a potent cytokine that promotes synovitis. B cells further the pathogenic process through antigen presentation, an autoantibody, and cytokine production. Joint damage begins at the synovial membrane, where the influx and or local activation of molecular cells and the formation of new blood vessels cause synovitis. Pannus, highly vascular granulation tissue, formed between the joint margins, reducing mobility and leading to potential joint immobility. Pannus destroys adjacent cartilage, joint capsule, and bone. The inflammatory process, synovitis, advances as the congestion and edema develop in the synovial membrane and joint capsule. Antigen-activated CD4+ T cells amplify the immune response by stimulating other molecular cells. Synovial fibroblasts, chondrocytes, and osteoclasts, the release of cytokines, especially TNF, alpha, IL-6, and IL-1, causes synovial inflammation. In addition to the articular effects, pro-inflammatory cytokines promote the development of systemic effects, including production of acute phase proteins such as CRP, anemia of chronic disease, cardiovascular disease and osteoporosis, and affects the hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis, resulting in fatigue and depression. Pathophysiology and associated physical signs of rheumatoid arthritis. Presentation of antigen to T cells, to T and B cells proliferation, angiogenesis in synovial lining, to neutrophil accumulation in synovial fluid, cell proliferation, no cartilage invasion, swelling in small joints associated with pain, stiffness, and fatigue. Stages of RA. Stage 1, early, no disruptive changes on X-ray. Stage 2, evidence of osteoporosis on X-ray with or without slight bone or cartilage destruction, joint deformities, adjacent muscle atrophy, presence of extra articular tissue. Stage 3, severe, evidence of cartilage and bone destruction, osteoporosis, joint deformity, subluxation, ulnar deviation or hyperextension, extensive muscle atrophy, nodules, tenosynovitis. Stage 4, terminal, fibrous or bony ankylosis plus stage 3 criteria. Clinical manifestations, early stages, edematous, warm, tender joints. 2, limited range of motion and stiffness in affected joints. 3, generalized edema or nodules around affected joints. 4, impaired mobility and ability to perform activities of daily living, ADLs. 5. Fatigue, weakness, and anorexia. 6. Weight loss, fever. Clinical manifestations. Advanced stage of hurry. Patients experience joint stiffness after periods of inactivity. Morning joint stiffness may last for 60 minutes to several hours. 2. Deformity and disability. Inflammation and atrophy of joint structures. 3. Muscle atrophy and tendon destruction around the joints causes one articular surface to slip past the other. Subluxation. 4. Typical distortions of the hand include ulcer drift, zigzag deformity, swan neck, boutonniere deformities, metatarsal head subluxation, hallux valgus union on the feet. Laboratory and diagnostic studies. 1. History and physical examination. 2. Rheumatoid factor RF are present in less than 80% of clients with RA. 3. Erythrocyte sedimentation rate ESR significantly elevated. 4. C-reactive protein CRP elevated. Elevated ESR and CRP are indicators of active inflammation. 5. Antinuclear antibody. 6. Complete blood count. Red blood cell count and C4 complement components are decreased. 6. Radiographic studies reveal abnormalities such as progressive joint damage, not diagnostic of RA in early stages of disease. Management of RA. There are basically four goals in the management of a client with RA. 1. Reducing inflammation. 2. Controlling the pain experience. 3. Maintaining joint function. 4. Preventing or minimizing joint deformity. Key considerations in management. 1. Nutritional and weight management counseling. 2. Therapeutic exercises. 3. Rest and joint protection. Use of assistive devices. 4. Heat and cold applications. 5. Drugs. Disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs. DMARDs. Methotrexate sulfasalazine. Intra-articular or systemic corticosteroids, methylprednisolone, NSAIDs, ibuprofen, piroxicam, diclofenac, biological or targeted therapy, etanercept, anakinra, reconstructive surgery, implants, arthroplasty, physical assessment, joint pain, swelling, ROM, general health status. Evaluate psychosocial needs, social support, emotional stress, sexual satisfaction, financial constraints, vocation and career limitations, environmental concern, home or work modifications, suppress inflammation, prescribe drugs, NSAIDs, DMARD, careful timing to reduce early morning stiffness, use heat and cold compress, rest, teach relaxation techniques, joint protection, lightweight splints to rest inflamed joints and prevent deformity from muscle spasms and contractures. Remove splints at regular intervals to give skin care and perform ROM exercises. Plan care around patient's morning stiffness, e.g. sitting or standing in a warm shower, sitting in a tub with warm towels around the shoulders, soaking the hands in a basin of warm water to reduce stiffness and enhance ADL. Firm mattress to promote good body alignment. Encourage positions of extensions. Avoid positions to flexion. Sprints and casts may be helpful to maintain proper alignment and rest when inflammation is present. Lying prone for 30 minutes twice daily is recommended. Never place pillows under the knees to decrease joint contracture. Small flat pillow for head and shoulders. Joint protection. Work done in short periods with scheduled breaks to avoid fatigue. Pacing, energy conservation techniques, assistive devices, heat and cold therapy and exercises relieve stiffness, pain and muscle spasms. Ice is helpful in exacerbations. Moist heat for chronic stiffness. Heat application should not exceed 20 minutes. Cold application 10 to 15 minutes at a time. Therapeutic exercise program with physical therapist to improve flexibility and strength of affected joints. Physiological support. Explain nature, cause of disease, goals of therapy to enhance compliance. Complications of RA. Uncontrolled or poorly treated RA may result in the following complications. 1. Carpal tunnel syndrome. From compression of the median nerves that control sensation and movement in the hands. This results in symptoms such as aching, numbness, and tingling in the thumb, fingers, and part of the hand. Widespread inflammations, pleurisy, pericarditis, scleritis, or Sjögren's syndrome, vasculitis. Permanent damage to the joints and joint deformities. Cervical myelopathy, osteoporosis, coronary artery disease, anemia, early death. We have come to the end of